guys, it's Carrie. Today I'm doing an update on my sauropod collection. Diplodocus. The long neck may have been used to forage for food in forests that would have been inaccessible due to their massive size, and also for poking their head into wetlands to get mosses and ferns where they could stand on firm ground. Sauropod lifespans may have been of the order of 100 years. I love the blue paint on the face. An amazing dinosaur and an amazing paint job. Subscribe and give a thumbs up if you like sauropods. There's a fun ending on today's video. Another Diplodocus. Diplodocus had a row of spines running down its back. Its backbone had extra bones, giving its name, which means double beam. These would help support and move its neck and tail. It may have used its whip-like tail for protection. Diplodocus could not hold their necks over about 17 feet off the ground. I love the color of this dinosaur. I actually want to draw and paint a picture of this Diplodocus. Can you tell me what size egg Argentinosaurus laid? Was it the size of a tennis ball or a rugby ball? Ampelosaurus was a medium-sized sauropod from the late Cretaceous period. It had a long neck and walked around on four thick but slow legs. It was a type of titanosaur. It was closely related to Sauropoda. It had armor-like plating called osteoderms that ran all the way down its back to the beginning of the tail. It may have been for extra protection against the powerful jaws of predators. Alamosaurus lived during the late Cretaceous period. I really like those four column-like legs. It had a long neck, a whippy tail, and bulky body. It grew to about 69 feet in length. Its body was partly covered in bony armor. Apatosaurus lived during the late Jurassic period and was one of the largest land animals that ever existed. Its small head had a long skull and was less than 2 feet or 60 centimeters long, with its nostrils on the top of its head. It had a long 50-foot whip-like tail and four massive slow-moving column-like legs. Its hind legs were larger than the front legs. Fossilized footprint tracks have been found that were about 3 feet or 1 meter wide. Lafungosaurus was a herbivore from the early Jurassic period. This strange dinosaur had large, powerful hind legs and smaller arm-like front legs. It could use its strong back legs to stand straight up to reach the top of trees. It then used its arm-like front legs to put the food into its mouth. It had sharp claws with an especially large thumb claw, which could have been used for raking foliage from the trees. Europasaurus lived in the late Jurassic period. It was unusually small for a Jurassic sauropod. It was a dwarf dinosaur that lived in present-day Germany. This dwarf species developed due to the limited amount of available food on the island that it lived on. Its head was very small with a crest on top. It had short and stocky legs with a thick and moderately long tail. The Europasaurus was a herbivore like other sauropods. It derived its sustenance from the shrubs and trees of the European islands. Plateosaurus, or flat lizard, lived in the late Triassic through to the early Jurassic period. It had a long tail, long hind limbs, and a small head at the end of a long neck. The teeth were leaf-shaped and the jaws beak-like. Although it walked on four legs, paleontologists believe it could rear up on its hind legs and use its powerful clawed hands to pull in succulent branches. Plateosaurus belonged to a group known as the prosauropods and was a relative, although not an ancestor, of the gigantic sauropods of the Jurassic and Cretaceous period. Rhoetosaurus lived in Queensland, Australia. It is a genus of sauropod dinosaur from the Jurassic period of what is now Eastern Australia. It had powerful elephant-like legs and its name means Trojan reptile. It had an average build of up to 17 meters or 55 feet in length and weighed around 20 tons. Argentinosaurus, I've got twins. It may have been the largest dinosaur. It had a long neck, a long tail, and a small head. It probably used its long neck to reach into conifers or sweep the ground in search of ferns and bushes. Argentinosaurus laid eggs about the size of a rugby ball. Brachiosaurus. I really like the green colour on this dinosaur. It lived during the middle to late Jurassic period. It was one of the tallest and largest dinosaurs. It had a long neck, small head with the nostrils on the top of the head, and a short thick tail. Brachiosaurus lived on land. Most predators like Allosaurus and Ceratosaurus were half its size. Their best defense was their size, plus their clawed feet and tail. Camarasaurus lived in the late Jurassic period. It had a small, square-shaped head with a blunt snout. It had a long neck, thick legs, and a long tail, which served as a counterbalance to the neck. Its front legs were slightly shorter than the hind legs. Camarasaurus had five toes on the front feet with a long sharp claw on the inner toe, which was used as a weapon against predators. Natural enemies of young Camarasaurus would have been Allosaurus, Ceratosaurus, and Torvosaurus. Jobaria lived during the Cretaceous period. It used its scoop-like teeth to eat plants and had a long flexible neck. It had one large claw on the inner toe of each front foot and smaller claws on its hind feet. Its neck contained 12 vertebrae. Jobaria fossils have been found together, which indicates that it was a herding animal. Juvenile Brachiosaurus. I really like the green colour and red crest. Diplodocus. A really nice model and I love the tail there. Its front legs were shorter than its back legs. It had elephant-like legs with five-toed feet. Notice that large thumb claw. Its head was less than 2 feet with nostrils on the top of the head. It was among the longest land animals ever. It may have used its whip-like tail and claws for protection. Cetiosaurus lived during the late Jurassic period. It was a huge, long-necked, long-tailed dinosaur with a tiny head and a bulky body, Although it had a shorter tail and neck than most sauropods, the forelimbs were relatively long and it walked on all four legs. It probably lived near water. This dinosaur was originally thought to be a crocodile-like animal. Its name means whale lizard. This is a brachiosaurus hatchling. You can see it's just coming out of the egg there. This is all part of a life cycle series. And here's the juvenile. The clawed feet in the young were extra long. And the adult size. It grew to about 85 feet or 27 meters and weighed up to 88 tons. Brachiosaurus had about 52 teeth, 26 teeth in each jaw. It used its chisel-like teeth to graze the tops of the trees, swallowing food whole. Apatosaurus may have used its tail as a third leg in order to reach and graze very tall vegetation. Apatosaurus hatched from enormous eggs that were about 1 foot or 30 centimeters in diameter. The vertebrae had a groove along the top. This held a strong ligament that supported the weight of the neck and tail, like the cables on a suspension bridge. The tail would counterbalance the head. I really like this model, and I've painted a picture of this actual model. I'm going to show it to you at the end. Brachiosaurus. I really like the green colour of this model. It's really nice. Lots of good detail there too. Brachiosaurus walked on four legs. Notice that the front legs were longer than its hind legs. The longer front legs and its very long neck made Brachiosaurus look rather giraffe-like, reaching heights of up to 40 to 50 feet tall. Daxiatitan was a very large dinosaur, reaching up to 69 feet or 21 meters in length. It had an enormously long neck which helped it find leaves and plants. I really like all the detail on this one and the color and lots of osteoderms. Brachiosaurus. I really like these two large models. Lots of attention to detail. Each foot had five toes with a long sharp claw on the first toe of each foot and the claws on the first three toes of each rear foot. The sculpt is excellent and the head turns back, like the dinosaur is looking to see if there's any danger around. Very good detail on the head there. Another great Brachiosaurus model. Great detail, especially the head. Have a look at that. That's really nice. Notice on the front feet, the toes are long and column-like, in a vertical position, giving extra height and that giraffe-like appearance. And here's another quick look at Apatosaurus and my painting I did of it. I drew it freehand and then just painted and texted it in. Cool dinosaur. I have some other videos on how to draw dinosaurs and animals, and I'll be adding to that collection as well. There's a fun ending coming up soon. Please stay and watch another video with me. Thank you for watching my video. See you again soon. See you guys in my next video.